is Mike Ball from WordPress.com, and today I'm going to walk you through how to navigate the new elements in full site editing. This is a feature set that just came out with WordPress 5.9, and it gives you some really nice controls over the whole span of your website. So whereas before you couldn't edit headers and footers, now you can. Whereas before it wasn't always easy to change colors and fonts and things across your whole website, now it's super easy. So you can see right now I have a website open. Doesn't even look like we're in the editor right now, but you can see with this bar up here we are. So the first thing we're going to look at is the WordPress logo button over on this side. I've never really used this before, but I found out with this release it lets you jump around between what you're actually editing. So if I go ahead and open it up, it's going to give me a few different options. So right now we're in the site editor, we have a template selected, and we're going to be editing that. You can also see I can zoom in on different templates or switch between different templates I want to edit. That looks like this. And it kind of gives you all the different kind of container options that are used across your site. And then there's template parts. And these are different pieces that you can swap in and out on the different templates on your site. So if I wanted to use one header for my home page and I wanted to use a different one for my index page, I could. So we're going to go back to the normal editor. And now you're back to the site again. The block outline is something that's been around for a while. It's this little list view right here. We're going to open it up, and immediately what you're going to see is new is this header section here, and that kind of brings you to that focus, and this footer section down here at the bottom, and that'll take me down to the bottom of the page. Within each of these sections, you can see the blocks that exist in those kind of groups. You can see I have social icons, you can see I have latest Instagram posts, and it's really easy to just drag and drop and change any of these. So if I wanted to put YouTube first, that's all I have to do. I don't have to mess with the editor, I don't have to go to the block settings, I don't have to click any other arrows. I can just drag and drop things within kind of this list view, which is really cool. So if I close that down, the next thing we're gonna see over here is this new kind of half moon looking icon right here, and this is called styles. So I'm going to open that up, and this is going to open kind of the global styles for your entire site. I'm going to move my face out of the way for a second. You can see it kind of shows you your fonts, the colors selected, and the background color here, that black, actually reflects the background I have selected for the site. So for example, if I go into this color section right here and I want to change this background color to white, which is not going to look good, but I'm going to show you. And we go back, you're going to see the colors that are in that little icon change. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to change that back to black. And then you can see as I scroll through the site, I can change things like links, and they'll change live as I'm editing the site. I have banana yellow for Star Wars selected here, since that makes sense. I'm going to leave it that way. You can also change different fonts that you're using across the site. You can change font size and some different options that are in there. If I wanted to make my normal text line height, say if it was looking like it was too close together, I can manually adjust that and give it more space, or I can shrink it closer together if it was looking like too bloated or too spaced out. I can also set custom sizes here or use these general kind of font styles and variations here to change kind of how the site looks overall. And that's specifically the body text. Links is the same thing, but that's going to apply to anywhere you're using links, especially in like post headlines like we have with the query block right here, which is just set up to show a list of posts based on kind of what settings I give it. So the other thing that kind of changes is when you change or save any of the edits that you've been working on, it's actually going to give you a more granular option set to choose what you want to save. So right now I have all of them selected. Say if I was working on the footer only and I didn't make any changes or didn't mean to make any changes to the site overall or the navigation menus, I could uncheck those just to make sure I don't accidentally break something. I didn't do anything important worth saving right now, so I'm not going to save it. But those are kind of the new ways to navigate around full site editing. There's a lot of really cool things within each of those sections.